That is what is the difficulty of collaborating technology with human interventions. Meanwhile, may I request our convener, Shri Chas Jishra sir, to kindly come up on the dais and welcome our speaker, Shri Rajesh Kamath Saab, the co-founder and director of Chanakya Consultancy.
Mr. Rajesh Kamath is a consultant, facilitator, coach, teacher, author, columnist, storyteller, and speaker. He is well known for combining the best practices of Western and Indian management science. He has worked with large business houses including the Mahindra Group and others. He was instrumental in setting up Bodhi Vriksha, the management development center of the Mahindra Group. He has been on SHRM's Advisory Council and People Matters Jury for Are You in the List, an initiative to spot India's best young HR talent. He also co-founded More Than HR Global, MTHRG, in 2002. He is one of the leading facilitators on the Strategy Academy. He has founded the Living Philosophy Studied Group. He does keynote sessions and writes for Indian and international magazines. He's also a mentor to startups and is on the advisory board for business schools. He is speaking on Leadership Transformation for Excellence in the Normal in SHRM 2021.
We welcome you, sir, on the behalf of entire NCL as well as HR fraternity. Thank you so much, sir. A really eloquent and electrifying speaker we are going to have on board. Welcome again, sir. Shri Rajesh Kamath Saab, over to you. Thank you so much.
You can have my PPT on in a few minutes. So I always say two things required in any event, conference, training. Two things. The first is a smile on the face. So I'm hoping all of you can smile a little bit more. Aur dusri cheez hai taliya. Can we clap for all of you? The speaker is because of all of you. Agar audience nahi hai, to speaker ka koi matlab nahi. Just think about it. And as far as digital and people are concerned, I think debate aaj bahut achhi tarah clarify ho gaya. Technology did not correct itself, but it got replaced by humans whenever it was required. So please understand, technology ka moolya tabhi hai jab hamare presence mein that technology is available. Otherwise it has no value. So it is also for the user, which is the human. Aur aaj main baat karne wala hu not about Google or Apple, ये कोई भी कंपनी के बारे में मैं बात नहीं करने वाला. जो भी उदाहरण है, other than maybe one or two, I'm going to speak everything about our nation, because that's what matters. And I always feel more proud when I speak for our own companies, rather than companies which have made their name multinationally in, you know, various fields. Because I think that matters much more. Kya ho gaya that in the quest for technology, modernity, futuristic thinking, hum kabhi kabar bhool jate hain ki sara jo uska foundation hai, yahi par uski shuruaat hui. I gave you example yesterday that even if you think of both technology and people management, technology, I gave you an example yesterday of wireless, jo Nikola Tesla ne foundation rakha, uski neev thi Swami Vivekanand, kyunki unhone Vedanta ka ke do elements, प्राण और आकाश इसके बारे में बताया, बिकॉज ऑफ विच टेस्ला कुड थिंक. आकाश मीन्स नॉट जस्ट द वे वी थिंक ऑफ स्काई, बट आकाश इज एन एलिमेंट विच लूजली वी ट्रांसलेट एज ईथर, दो इट इज नॉट ईथर इन द रियल सेंस. सो ही थॉट इफ देर इज नो मीडियम लाइक वायर, हाउ कैन इट बी ट्रांसमिटेड? कैन ईथर बी द ट्रांसमिटर? Can there be no wire? That's how the idea came about. So most things come from Indian management, my dear friends. Aur last 9 years, maine sara bitaya hai in integrating Indian and Western modern management. And that's where I studied more and more about Chanakya ya Kautilya. Aaj hum Chanakya Niti bolte hain, to everybody thinks kuch galat karna matlab Chanakya Niti. Friends, this is the disaster of our nation. हम खुद के बारे में नहीं जानते, लेकिन हम Elon Musk के बारे में पता करते हैं और broadcast भी करते हैं. We know much more about Steve Jobs than we know about Vivekanand. And I ask in so many conferences, how many of you have heard about, especially when they are youngsters, and I ask them that how many of you have heard about Panchatantra, for example, other than people in my generation or pehle wala generation, people who are younger than 30 years over here, raise your hands. Those who are younger than 30 years, please raise your hands. Okay. How many of you have heard of Panchatantra? Okay, many of you. That too because Indian audiences of an Indian company. I can tell you from my experiences that not even 5% of people in audiences I go to know about Panchatantra. Aur hum kya sochte hain Panchatantra kya hai? Bachchon ki kahaniya. I want to tell you it's the biggest mistake we've made. That these are just examples jo main aapse share kar raha hu. That's not the complete part of my presentation or my topic today. Lekin aapko just do udaharan dena chahta tha jo hum nahi jante. That whether the concept of wireless came because of Vivekanand, the concept of people management was set by Kautilya, the concept of so many things including talent management has come from Panchatantra. Ab humne padha hi nahi hai to kaise pata chalega? So we need to study our own things. Everyone says go into the future. Main aapse guarantee deta hu, aapko guarantee deta hu, you have to go into the past to be able to design the future. Kyunki hamare eternal wisdom, I call it Indian eternal wisdom, not ancient, because it is timeless. To hamare eternal wisdom mein aapko har cheez ke liye solutions milenge. Yesterday I gave you just one example. That coal is not the problem. The process of mining is the problem. Please find out. And you will find it in our own wisdom. किसी ने रिसर्च नहीं किया है, बिकॉज वी थिंक मॉडर्न इज एवरीथिंग. एनीवे, सो दैट्स अ बेस. मैं आपसे पूछना चाहता हूं, एक और एक उदाहरण लेता हूं. ये श्रीफल क्यों देते हैं? एनीवन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ श्रीफल? एनीवन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ श्रीफल? व्हाई इज इट गिवन? हर गेस्ट को हमने दिया कल से. व्हाई इज इट गिवन? यू सी, ask about digital, everyone knows. So I'll give you the answer anyway. And my point is not to show you that we do not know. Lekin har cheez ka ek matlab hai. Shrifal, as you can probably translate, is a symbol of prosperity. But why is it a symbol of prosperity? It grows on the coastal regions. Ye aapko pata hai. And the water of coastal regions is salty. The water inside the coconut is sweet. How does it convert this salty into sweet? Where does the water come from in the first place? Secondly, hard outside, what's on the inside? Soft inside. And further inside, water. Friends, this represents the human consciousness. Why do we break coconut at every auspicious occasion? Surrender the human ego. Wo jo coconut hai, was actually the substitute that Vishwamitra ji thought of, the great Rishi Vishwamitra, that you don't need animal sacrifice. You just need to sacrifice your ego, which is represented by human. So, ye pura jo shrifal hai is representation of human, especially the physical form. Jab is ego ko surrender karte hai, so when I take it from you and I keep it here, I'm surrendering my ego to the divine. Okay? Such are the great spirits of India, my dear friend. To Bharat ke शास्त्रों को हम जब रिसर्च करेंगे उसको क्रेडिट देंगे. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर अ टाइम व्हेन ऑल स्पीकर्स विल स्पीक मोर अबाउट इंडिया. एंड बाय द वे प्रमोद जी, विनय, ऑल आर माय वेरी गुड फ्रेंड्स, बट मोर एंड मोर कॉन्फ्रेंसेस वी स्पीक अबाउट, एंड करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग, मोर अबाउट फॉरेन एग्जाम्पल्स. क्यों? तो कल मैंने आपको एक होमवर्क दिया था. किसने किया है? I'd ask you to research one person. Okay, wonderful. Vivek, right? If I remember right. So Vivek will, the sawal ye tha for those who were not there yesterday. Who is the person called Annadurai Rikshawala? What is he known for? Can you please give a mic to Vivek? And there was also a lady yesterday. Are you there? Yes. And give a mic there. Please tell us two things about Annadurai Rikshawala. Vivek and madam, aapka naam?
Hello.
Please give her the mic so that she can announce her name to others.
I'm Shravani. Shravani Chaudhary.
Shravani, is it?
Yes.
Oh, what a beautiful name. We'll come to why it's a beautiful name later. Not because she's a lady, but because the word Shravani is amazing. Yes, please.
Annadurai is the most famous rickshawala.
Correct.
Of the country. He wanted to be an entrepreneur, but due to his financial condition.
Can you turn taki logon ko bhi achhi tarah sunai de?
Actually, he wanted to be an entrepreneur, but उनका जो परिवार था, माता पिता उन्हें नहीं पढ़ा पाए और वो अशिक्षित रह गए. और उन्होंने सोचा, और वो बिजनेस करना चाहते थे, इसलिए उन्होंने ऑटो चुना. और उनका ये मानना था कि मेरा ऑटो दुनिया का सबसे बेस्ट ऑटो रहेगा. और जो सबसे बड़ी चीज़ उनके बारे में जो मैंने पढ़ी और जानी कि वे कस्टमर्स को अपना भगवान मानते थे. बाकी उनके ऑटो रिक्शा के बारे में बताने की जरूरत नहीं, उसमें बहुत सारी फैसिलिटीज, न्यूज़पेपर,
एक्सेलेंट
फ्रेज एंड ऑल.
जो लास्ट लाइन था, कस्टमर्स को
भगवान वो मानते हैं.
सुपर, वंडरफुल.
थैंक यू सर.
सो एक बात बिफोर आई कम टू श्रवणी मैम, दैट कस्टमर इज किंग इन फॉरेन लैंड्स, कस्टमर इज गॉड इन इंडिया. Okay, I'm giving you one clear difference. Service and seva are not the same thing. Customer seva is transaction, give and take. It has a clear meaning of jitna mujhe wapis milega in terms of money or whatever, generally money, utna hi main dunga. What about seva? There is no take. There is only give, give, give. There was a beautiful person playing the flute outside today. Are you here? The person who played the flute. Can we please clap for him? That is seva. I don't know if you got a chance to hear him. I'd be very happy if he can play during lunchtime, whoever wants to listen to him. He was doing an amazing job. सेवा इज जब आप देते हैं, नॉट विद द एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ रिसीविंग, बट यू विल स्टिल रिसीव एंड यू विल रिसीव मच मच मोर, बिकॉज योर माइंड सेट इज ऑफ भक्ति. एंड थैंक्स पाणी पंकज पांडे फॉर गिविंग द थ्री थिंग्स फ्रॉम द वेद. सो वी मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट इंडिया सो मेनी थिंग्स. वॉट डू वी से इज द हाइएस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ कस्टमर सर्विस? वी से कस्टमर डिलाइट. एक कंपनी में मैंने सुना थीम था कस्टमर ऑब्सेशन. आई सेड, आपने सुना है कस्टमर डिवोशन? व्हाई डोंट वी स्पीक ऑफ कस्टमर डिवोशन? वी आर वेटिंग फॉर मार्शल गोल्डस्मिथ और स्टीफन कोवी, लेट मिस्टर कोवी, और समवन एल्स टू कम अप विद अ न्यू टर्म. उसको हम फिर कॉपी करके देन वी विल मेक अ कॉन्फ्रेंस थीम. जो हमारे खुद की भाषा में है सेवा, इज सच एन अमेजिंग टर्म. एंड इवन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रांसलेट इट, it's customer devotion. Grahak seva is not customer service. Aur main aapko batana chahta hu that I've been on both sides. Both sides matlab, till the last 9 years, I was entirely on the path of Western management, thinking all of that. Kyunki mujhe pata hi nahi tha ki Bharat mein hai kya. Luckily, I took interest and I started studying a little bit of Indian wisdom. And today I can guarantee you, there is nothing in the world that has not come from India. Nothing. And whatever we hear are just repackaging of the same thing. And I'm not saying that Western world is bad, number one. I'm not saying what they teach is unimportant. But I'm saying we have to combine jo yahan par available hai with what is available in the modern world. And that is my theme today. So leadership paradigm change karna hai. Please don't come up with new terms for leadership. Just go back to what is available in India itself. Aur main aapko kuch examples aur kuch cases iske taur se, hopefully I should be able to convince that what we need to do is study India better and not study more and more of what's available overseas. Hamare desh mein aur hamare companyon mein, y'all are doing such an amazing job. Why don't we have example of Coal India, etc. in everything in management? Why do we need to quote the Google, etc.? We think they are doing great stuff. Friends, everything is taken from here. Anyways, coming back to Shravani. So madam, what is the meaning of your name? I hope you know it. Shravan ka matlab kya hai?
Basically, it's a name of a month, the rainy season. So,
and what has the name of the month come from?
So, my name is actually Shabuni because I'm a Bengali. And then what I've heard is like Shobon means it's one who has the capacity to hear.
Super, to wonderful. And it's the ability to listen, not listen. Hear.
Yeah, listen.
It's farak hai. So, jo mahina Shravan ka hai, has come from the faculty of Shravan. We have an entire month dedicated to listening beautifully, listening powerfully, and we still study listening in communication the Western way. So I'm giving you more and more examples of how Indian wisdom can give you, you know, portals to everything you want in any field. Anyways, madam, Anna Dorai Rikshawala, aur kya cheez hai jo Vivek saab ne nahi bataya?
Basically, he covered the most important thing, Atithi Deva Bhava, jiska, means that is his aim, motto of
Riksha
life.
Mein kya hai unka?
Riksha mein, he has
listen carefully.
Investments which he never thought that would give him returns, first of all. So, I have heard some of his TED Talks. Unhone bola hai ki, he invested some 8,000 rupees initially. Yes. And then after that, he didn't expect that he would get a return of 15,000 from there.
वैसे भी मेरा वॉल्यूम बढ़ा ही है लेकिन वो जो 8000 है किन-किन चीजों पर इन्वेस्ट किया है उन्होंने
पहले तो उन्होंने शुरू किया न्यूज़पेपर्स से सो ही स्टार्टेड विद सम 10 टू 20 न्यूज़पेपर्स
ओके
ऑफ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस सो दैट हूएवर गेट्स इनटू हिज रिक्शा वुड एंजॉय दोस देन ही स्टार्टेड विद सम अदर फैसिलिटीज लाइक टैबलेट्स एंड टेलीविजन And then after that, he also has, I think, in his auto rickshaw, he gives discounts. Like for some days, Valentine's Day, his birthday, then Women's Day, Children's Day, Children's Day, Father's Day. So he basically dedicates his small innovative thinking and then...
Right. Anything else? All are right. Jo bhi aapne kaha is perfect. And I'll share more with you all audiences. He's the most tech advanced guy as a rickshawala in the whole world.
Yes. He's technologically very advanced. Not only that, he unhone agar ek tablet kharida aaj, to wo badalte rehte wo do teen mahine baad. Like he is now, this technology is gone and I should advance it. So he invests on that again and he gets return also.
Superb. Unhone aapne jo video dekha usme, did he give what is his goal besides customer being the god? सुनने को आया? Do you know why he did not marry? That's not a joke, it's real.
No.
Okay, I'll come to that. Shravani ke liye zordar taliya. Let me tell you what he's got. And I'm telling you from personal experience, because I've met Annadorai Rikshawala. I have hosted him in a conference and I'm also in touch with him. And you must get him to NCL. Please listen to him. He's the guy to give you a talk on what is digital. You already heard, school bhi complete nahi kiya. Okay, incidentally, he wanted to be an entrepreneur. His brother was a rickshawala. Aur ek din, bhai bimar tha, so he did not want to waste the opportunity of making some money. It's important to the family. So rickshaw chalai. And here is what happened. The person who was sitting in his rickshaw, at one point in time, he was not able to get through his family. And he heard something about hospital, Annadorai Rikshawala. So he asked the person sitting in the customer, "Sir, kya hua?" He said, "My family member is in hospital, but I'm not able to get through." That's the day he decided that no customer will ever have a network problem in his rickshaw. So here are the things that he has. Newspaper, magazines, latest. He has a laptop, he has a tablet, and as ma'am said, every time it becomes a little old, he replaces with the newest model. He has a 65 liters, right, fridge, which has all the, hot drinks, but he has all the cold drinks over there. He has videos playing, and the videos are according to the needs of the customer. और अगर कस्टमर बाहर से आया है कोई भी अलग से स्टेट से आया है ही प्लेज म्यूजिक फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन फ्रॉम दैट स्टेट फ्रेंड्स एंड देयर इज अ लॉट मोर एंड ही हैज सिम कार्ड्स ऑफ ऑल पॉसिबल कंपनीज एंड ही हैज अ क्रेडिट कार्ड मशीन एंड ही हैज पेटीएम एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट यू नेम इट व्हाट यू वांट इन टेक्नोलॉजी हैड एंड आई कैन बेट यू ही विल बी मोर सैवी about all the technologies than many of us over here. This is my guarantee to you. Now, ma'am said about discounts. Main aapko batana chahta hun, this person, and I'll tell you about his purpose. And my purpose behind telling you about Annadorai Rikshawala. This person has 365 days, 24/7, for teachers, it is free. Any teacher teaching anywhere. Why he says, because I didn't get education, I have a lot of respect for education. And for all educators, I will have it free. Okay? In his talk in Chennai, jahan par humne host kiya, you spoke about discounts and various days. First of all, yes, he has discounts, wo sare din, birthdays wagera janta hai. But what completely amazed me, he knows the birthdays of Steve Jobs, of course, late Steve Jobs now. Of Elon Musk, of Jeff Bezos, of Anand Mahindra, you name it, at least 20, and he told us the birthdays. And agar wo company ka employee uske agar rickshaw mein baitha hai us birthday ke day, unke liye ride free. Friends, this guy was a human computer. Usko 20 CEO और उनके birthdays कंपनी के नाम और birthdays याद है. I mean, I can go on and on, but finally I must come to ये सब क्यों कर रहा है वो. That's important. He is not doing this to give TED talks. He is not doing this to become famous. He is not doing this because technology. I must be in tune with the times. First, it started with, as you rightly said, that customer is God. But there is more to it. And that's the beauty of it. So, ek audience mein ek person ne pucha ki aap aage kya karna chahte hain? Business kaise badhaoge? See, look at our questions also. We want to ask the rickshawala, tumhara business kaise badhega? Someone asked him, what is your turnover? By the way, I want to tell you, ma'am is absolutely right. His monthly investment is 8,000 and his monthly gains are 50 to 60,000. And people ask for him by name. Everyone wants to ride in auto. Annadora is auto. Because they want to experience him. Now we asked him, okay, now what? Do you want to kind of become more famous? What next? Will you become a speaker or something? Maybe you can make a, you know, become a speaker, author, mentor. Jaise mera resume mein likha tha. He said something amazing. He gave us data ki Chennai mein kitne rickshaw wale hai. Let's assume he said about 25,000. He said, I want to ensure every other rickshaw wala earns as much as I do. Please clap for Annadorai rickshaw wala. Phir se dohrata hun. He said, I want to ensure every single rickshaw wala in Chennai earns as much as I do. तो मैं उनको बताना चाहता हूं कि वो भी कैसे कस्टमर को गॉड बना के दे कैन अर्न एज मच एज आई डू. सो ही वॉन्ट्स कॉम्पिटिशन. ही डज नॉट कंसिडर दम एज कॉम्पिटिशन. ही कंसिडर्स देम एज फेलो ह्यूमन बींग्स. एवरी वन शुड बेनिफिट. आई वॉज स्टन्ड. वी ऑडियंसेस वर एक्चुअली स्मॉल इन आर माइंड सेट्स आस्किंग हिम, तुम बिजनेस कैसे बढ़ाओगे. एंड ही वॉज थिंकिंग ऑफ सारे रिक्शा वाला कम्युनिटी को, हाउ टू मेक देम रिच एंड प्रॉस्परस. सो द एम माई डियर फ्रेंड्स ऑफ ऑल डिजिटल इज टू क्रिएट प्रॉस्पेरिटी फॉर मैनकाइंड. ऑल राइट, यस, लेट्स गो टू द प्रेजेंट. ओ इट्स राइट हियर. विल इट कम ऑन बाय इटसेल्फ और आई नीड टू क्लिक हियर? यस, ओके, यस. So with that little background, or rather pretty long background, but don't worry, I'm not married to my slides. When my time is up, I will stop. You will anyways get enough from whatever I've spoken. Leadership transformation for excellence in the new normal. Isme teen cheeze hai, as you can see. Purpose, people, profit. And the sequence is selected accordingly. It is not by chance. So, sabse pehle kya aata hai? Purpose. Can we have all of you saying that what comes first? Purpose. Agar purpose aapka sahi nahi hai, profit is useless. I'm so sorry, but jab maine management seekha, in my first lecture I heard that the objective of all corporations is to make profit. How wrong our management is. It is to serve people. Profits will come. Annadorai Rikshawala is the example of that. I'm going to give you more examples. So, jab profit se shuruaat hoti hai, our leadership will go wrong. What did we experience in the last 2 years? Kisne kiya ye? Is nature trying to harass us, trouble us, finish us off? Who caused it? Humankind. We can blame China or whoever, but China is not apart from us as humans. Alright, so please note. And still there are plenty of companies who are making profit. Aapne dekha rahega. Tech or pharma companies have become rich by, I don't know, multiples. I don't want to cast aspersions on that, but you know that we have more and more doubt today about pharma companies and medical fraternity in general, even though the professions are very, very valuable. So, purpose, then the people who will do it, or uske baad profit. Let's look at examples other than Annadorai. Second example. Okay, Abhi, now picture is clear in front of you. But I want to ask you, without looking at that, can anyone tell me, and please think what's in your mind before jumping to conclusions, which is the largest, most productive eye care facility in the world? Aapke dimag mein pehle kya aata hai, you think? Sorry? Shankar Netralay. Any other? In the world, not talking about India. Arvind Eye Care. And even if it was Shankar, I'll be very happy. Friends, the largest, most profitable, most productive eye care facility in the world is in India. Ye case study hum kyun study nahi karte? I know some IIMs have included it, but not so much. So many audiences I ask again, that which is the largest eye care hospital in the world? It's never Arvind. This started in 76. Dr. V is no more, but it started with his singular vision, purpose, because I want to give you example of purpose, was to prevent needless blindness in the world. I repeat, prevent needless blindness in the world. Needless matlab, which if treated, taken care of in time, it won't occur. Because blindness can be prevented if it is addressed in time. And when Arvind Eye Care ki shuruaat hui thi, he started with 11 beds. Wo bhi ghar pe, jo bhi paisa tha, jo bhi jewelry tha, wo sab bechne ke baad he got money to start this. But imagine in the next 10 years, he grew to a size, I'm not talking branches, we'll come to that, how many hospitals are there, we'll see. But it became the largest, you know how? And I'm giving you figures of at least 5 years old because it keeps increasing. A minimum of 3 million patients are treated every year. Or aap khud study kijiye, because it is, there's so much in it, your mind will be boggled by how they do it. And he combined it with the efficiency of McDonald's. Matlab ajeeb baat hai. He said what McDonald's has achieved, this is a great combination of Indian and Western. He said McDonald's ka jo uniformity hai, reach hai, affordability hai, standard quality hai, all that I want in eye care. They created an Arvind Eye Care system where the doctors, the eye surgeons, handle only the most important part, which is typically the replacement of the eye lens. For the rest, there are paramedics, extremely well trained, who handle everything else. So a single surgery may, just guess, you know, normally, agar aap khud ek eye surgeon ke paas gaye ya aapke parent ko leke gaye, for a typical eye lens replacement surgery, how much time does it take normally? Anyone? How much time for the end-to-end operation? Half an hour? Anyone else with any other figure? 45 minutes? Guess how much time Arvind does it in? About 7 to 8 minutes. And 4 patients are treated at one time in assembly line kind of treatment. The quality of the treatment is very high. Lekin aise system banaya ki 4 patient ko ek saath kar sakte hain, because the doctor is only replacing the lens, the paramedics are handling everything else. So jo ek time ka replacement hai with one patient has been multiplied into 4. Now you multiply that by the number of days in the month and the year. Look at what the numbers go to. By the way, the story doesn't end here. I want to tell you 2 more facts, which will again surprise you. Of course, aajkal wo thoda sa, some others, including Shankar Netralaya, I think have done the same. If customer is God, how do they do it? Out of 3 million patients who are treated every year, 2 million are treated free. 2 million, 2/3 of their patients are treated free of charge. The reason is because the poor and the underprivileged in the country are so large, and they are typically the customer segment which Arvind addresses. Kyunki garib jo hai, वो जाता ही नहीं है आई डॉक्टर के पास, तो आंखें खराब होके दे बिकम ब्लाइंड और उसके बारे में कुछ नहीं करते बिकॉज पैसा नहीं है. एंड देन फाइनली एज अरविंद रिसर्च शोज, गरीबों की जब आंखें जाती है दे बिकम यूजलेस एंड दे आर नॉट ट्रीटेड एज ह्यूमंस एट ऑल. सो एक्चुअली दे एंड अप डाइंग ऑल्सो अर्लियर. सो फेटैलिटी इज लिंक्ड टू पॉवर्टी एंड दे हैव डन सो मच ऑफ अ ग्रेट सर्विस. एंड हाउ डू दे डू इट, इवन दिस टू थर्ड्स कैसे ट्रीट होता है, बिकॉज द वन थर्ड पेशेंट्स एक्चुअली एंड अप, बिकॉज द नंबर्स आर सो हाई, they end up subsidizing the cost for the other two, including the eye care products, which are all manufactured within Arvind. So it's amazing story. Aur ek cheez batana chahta hu, wo jo 2 lakh patients or 2 million or 20 lakh patients hai, where do they come from? Do they visit the hospital? They don't. Arvind goes to them. So every single hospital, there are about 7 or 8 facilities right now, okay, in Tamil Nadu. The every hospital goes to the slums and they go and check the doctors, go and check the eyes of all the poor people, the residents of the slums. Or jahan par bhi they see there is a need for eye care, they actually convince them to come to the hospital saying that it is 100% free. So they put them in the bus, get them to the hospital, perform the operation, let them be there for post-operation care, and then get them back, everything for no money. Friends, think about the purpose of Dr. V and how he has converted it into a profitable organization. They are not surviving on the grants. They are a profitable organization. Of course, they have made it as a trust. So they, in real terms, they are not counting their monies and putting themselves as, you know, this much crore revenue and all of that. Sara trust mein jata hai. Everything is put back for the welfare of humans. Friends, these are the kind of cases we should be studying. Isn't this an amazing story? Don't you think we must give them a big round of applause? Aur bahut sari cheez hai. It's outstanding. This is seva. This is Atithi Devo Bhava. This is customer is God. Alright, let's go ahead. Yes, you can think about isme se kya seekh milti hai aur hum isme se kya apply kar sakte hai, atmasat kar sakte hai and use in our day-to-day lives. Okay, all HR professionals and other professionals, please think, what am I thinking? What is my purpose in life? Is it to make a career or is it to make humanity better? We all want the country to be good, the world to be good, people to be good to us. Usme hamara kya contribution hai? Kya hum ye sochte hain? Definitely today's business management schools don't teach this. I tell you this assured because I visit several of them. And most of what I teach is opposite of what they are taught. But kab aayega? All of this is there in our own thing. G.R.D. Tata. You know many stories about it, so I'm not going to talk too much about it. Bahut sari kahani I've collected about G.R.D.'s life. I didn't get a chance to meet him because he passed away much earlier. But this man, I don't know how many of you are aware, he was not even a graduate. And from 30 companies when he took over, you may say, "Arey, wo Tata hai, so he can do it." He started as an apprentice. And from 30 companies, he took it to 95 companies, including TCS, which is the largest company and among the top 5, at least by market cap in the world. Was responsible for it. What did he know of IT? Nothing. He just put his faith in F.C. Kohli, the man who created. Even F.C. Kohli was an engineer, lekin computer engineer nahi tha, electrical engineer tha. What a organization they've created. But where do profits of Tata's go? I'm sure you know about Tata Trust. Kitna jata hai profits in Tata Trust? 66% of profits go in Tata Trust. By the way, I've never worked with Tatas. Okay. But you have to appreciate. They may not have studied. I'm not sure whether G.R.D. Tata's studied Indian wisdom. I don't think so. I've never read it anywhere. But his principles were completely Indian. He said, what's good for India is good for Tatas. Long before today, you know, few may say that. But most think that what's good for us is good for the company. Who says what's good for India is good for? Maybe public sector companies, great companies like yours. Okay, so that's the second example. I didn't know, ye, by the way, ye mera presentation, few of these slides, main barson se use kar raha hun. You know whom we are talking about? I did not know this will become a public debate in recent times, if you are reading the news. Who is this? Alexander. Now this has become a debate. But even I said the same. Leader who was called great, Alexander. What did he do? Of course he was a great commander. There's no doubt about it. He was a great military strategist. But he was also a barbarian who had to kill men, women and children to grab the lands. Are they role models for leadership? They cannot be. Then how do we call them great? But on the other hand, let's go to Kautilya, Chanakya, Vishnugupta. By the way, those who have not studied Chanakya ever, okay, I'm sure there'll be several. Hamare man mein hamesha ye duvida rehti hai, isn't he a grey figure? Unless we study, we'll never know. So please don't take my word for it. Main jo bhi kahunga, aap khud study kijiye, research kijiye. And there's lot available. Aisa nahi hai ki available nahi hai. Aap agar khud hoke study, not read. Because reading is very light. And I can give you the sources also, what to study. I'll give you my coordinates at the end. If you really want to study, I will put you on the path for it. Alexander conquered, I'm not giving you the whole story, just few examples. Alexander conquered whole of Greece, first of all, he annexed. His father Philip was only the king of a small part of Greece called Macedon. Ye aapko shayad pata hoga. Alexander managed to annex the whole of Greece. Then he marched eastwards. And then he first conquered Egypt. And then he conquered what was called as Persia, modern day Iran. And then he marched towards India. Friends, such a great commander who has managed to actually conquer at that point of time two big civilizations, Egypt and Persia, were not weak. Should have easily conquered India, especially because un dinon mein Bharat was not Bharat the way we know it today. Bharat was 16 Mahajanpad. Sirf landmass ek tha. Saat mein the, lekin Bharat nahi tha. There were 16 kingdoms with many small kingdoms and principalities within them. How easy? Just fight them one by one, finish them. But a teacher called Chanakya, whose actual name was Vishnugupta Kautilya, by the way, you must know this. His name is Chanakya, because some of you will know. His father's name was Chanak, who was also an Acharya. And Kautilya, another great misunderstanding, I'm trying to clarify many misconceptions, does not come from the word kutil. It comes from the word Kautil, jo ek gotra hai, which we know now, gotra is a gene pool. Gotra is also not some ancient belief. We still use it. So Kautil gotra se Kautilya. So he thought that this is a great time. Jaise pandemic mein, at least the world tried to come together. When the invaders have attacked the Greeks, Yavan Sena led by Alexander, is the time to unite these 16 kingdoms who otherwise are at loggerheads and fighting each other. And under his leadership, long story short, aap khud padhenge to aapko pata chalega. Long story short, he identified one young boy, could have been anyone from here, called Chandragupta. Surname Maurya. Maurya did not come from royal blood. He did not say, I want someone who is a prince, whose father is a king, jo IIT se padha hai, IIM se padha hai. He didn't say all that. No disrespect at all. By the way, I'm very, very fond of and proud of Indian institutions also. But he did not look for brand, aapka experience, all of that. He looked for what in HR we call as competence. And potential. Agar ye hai, rest can be trained. And he trained him to become the future leader of Akhanda Bharat for the first time. Akhanda matlab? Undivided. So, pehli baar, around 300 BC, 16 kingdoms were put together. Aur tab bana tha Akhanda Bharat. Uske pehle Bharat was never a single political identity. Shayad zarurat mehsoos hi nahi hui. So, we have names like Jambudvip, Aryavart. Bharat, as Akhanda Bharat, came out for the first time under Kautilya. Now, I want to tell you one thing which I find mind-boggling, that corporate executives have never studied this. We are trying to become a superpower. Correct, no? We are trying to become a superpower. For how long has human civilization existed, dear friends? Approximately. Can we take it as 10,000 years? 10,000 years later. From, BC times, going to request him to just, from BC times, because Chanakya ke times say we know, we also know from Vedic times, but let's take from Chanakya times. And from recorded economic history of India and the world, by the way, till 7th century AD or CE as it's called, current era, there were only two superpowers, India and China. Those century, we know the reasons, invaders and all of that. India has been a very, initially a poor economy, and then now we are getting back. So in the whole history of mankind, for almost 90% of the time, India has been a superpower. So for 2 years, now we are going to, for two centuries that we were apparently not a superpower, we are saying we are an underdeveloped nation, developing nation, third world country. What nonsense. So these are all ideas put into our mind. To me, there has only been one superpower since time immemorial. China, of course, was a great civilization. They've lost it, according to me. They may have wealth, but it's the Alexander way. And that is India. So, Bharat ke bare mein, you must feel pride all the time, my dear friends. And I'm going to give you a few more, and then we will have a little bit of Q&A. I want to tell you just the last point. Kautilya Arthashastra or Chanakya Niti. People probably, without knowing, they say Chanakya Niti, Chanakya Niti. Ye do cheezon mein bahut farak hai. Arthashastra was written for the leaders, the people in governance, the kings and ministers. Chanakya Niti was written for the common people. Look at the way Chanakya thought. He was the master of segmentation. Jo marketing mein study karte, target audience. And look at the branding. Kautilya Arthashastra, Chanakya Niti, naam bhi alag. So he thought, if the leaders, people in leadership can follow their code of conduct and all the principles of leadership, and people in common, society can follow their code of conduct, what an amazing society it was. This will create prosperity. Arthashastra is not economics. Another mistake. Artha is prosperity in the broadest sense. Of course, it also means money. Lekin artha ke bahut sare artha hai. And Shastra is the science. The science of creating prosperity for humanity, for the world, for India, for your home, for the individual is Arthashastra. And it is a masterpiece on management, my dear friends. आप पढ़ोगे तो अपना मैनेजमेंट जो भी अभी तक पढ़ा है अनलर्न कर दोगे, आई गारंटी टू यू, इट्स अमेजिंग. आई जस्ट गेव यू वन एग्जाम्पल येस्टरडे ऑफ एम्प्लॉई एंगेजमेंट फर्स्ट बींग प्रपोज बाय चाणक्य. सो एवरीथिंग इज देयर. ओके, सो व्हाट डू वी लर्न फ्रॉम वॉट एवर वी हर्ड सो फार. चाणक्य's पर्पस वॉज पहले अखंड भारत, और भारत जुड़ने के बाद देन इट वॉज उत्तिष्ठ भारत. उत्तिष्ठ भारत इज अ इंडिया विच इज कंटिन्यूअसली राइजिंग, इवॉल्विंग, ग्रोइंग. लुक एट हिज पर्पस. ही डिड नॉट से माय टी फर्स्ट ऑल यू मस्ट थिंक हाउ डिड अ टीचर हु हैड नो आर्मी, नो अथॉरिटी, नो मनी, नो वेपन्स, माई गॉड द पर्सन वॉज एबल टू ब्रिंग इंडिया टूगेदर एंड इंस्टॉल as its king a young boy whom he has trained entirely and groomed him. It must be an outstanding individual. Jitna padho kam hai uske bare mein. By the way, for those who think oh Chanakya is an ideology, friends, it is not. Please unbrainwash yourself if you believe that way. Chanakya does not believe belong to those who are today we call it, you know, whatever you want to call it, the rightist and all of this. Sari cheeze galat hai. Aap khud padhoge, then you will come to them. So, all of this, I arrive at OAR leadership. And I say, this is a great example of that. But we will skip that. What is OAR? This is my first framework. If you want, you can please click a picture of that. By the way, all the slides are available for you. Okay, nothing remains with me, it's all for you. Ownership of purpose, number one. Accountability towards people and responsibility for profits. By the way, Chanakya himself said artha eva pradhana, and here by artha he meant wealth. But he did not say artha is the artha, because artha also means objective. He did not say that's the goal. The goal is prosperity of humankind. Okay, so this is the first input I want to give you. I hope you got it. Just a couple more. Okay, I'll skip this in the interest of time, because I know that we are already running late. But it's very beautiful, and I can share a lot more at a different time. What all is there in Arthashastra? There is management, economics, warfare and strategy, law, foreign policy, everything in HR is there. So I say, Chanakya was an HR man, most of all, amongst many other things. Okay, I want to come to this. Okay, this is the second framework I want to share today. If I ask people over here, what is your definition of leadership? You will probably try and quote someone. Ya fir aap bologe, leadership means vision. Leadership means having charisma. Leadership means carrying people with you. Is there any one definition of leadership that applies to everyone over here? Probably not. Chanakya has clarified. Chanakya has clarified. Ye model ko dekhiye. Chanakya says, listen very carefully first, then you can also capture it. Has said, leadership is that which is a cycle consisting of four parts. I repeat, leadership, it is that which is a cycle consisting of four parts. This cycle is called Chatushtayam because of four parts. What are those four parts? And by the end of today's session, you will all remember this. I guarantee you that. The first part, he says, Alabdha Labartha, which is creation. Alabdha Labartha means, jo pehle nahi hai, to bring that into existence. Labha over here is not profit. How do you do that? By spotting opportunities, whether it is Dr. V or whether it is अन्नादोराय रिक्शा वाला और वेदर इट इज एनी कंपनी फॉर दैट मैटर, क्रिएशन बिगिंस देयर, है ना? बट उसके बाद क्या करना है? शुड वी जस्ट स्टॉप एट क्रिएशन? सो देन ही सेज लव द परिरक्षति, विच इज अबाउट फोकस कंसोलिडेशन. So after creation we need consolidation. After consolidation what comes? Because you, unless you strengthen your customer base, unless you bring in quality, unless you strengthen your people processes, unless you strengthen your treasury, you can't go on. But ek bar consolidate ho gaya, then he says rakshita vivardati. I repeat, rakshita vivardati, which is about expansion. How do you do that? By engendering and leveraging trust. So, jo company already bani hui hai can expand and diversify. Kyunki uska brand equity, the trust is already there, like Tata's. Right? Tata's has got back Tata Airways, which it had, Tata Airlines, which became Air India. शुरुआत कब हुई थी? 35 years back, 1935, which is almost 100 years back. But it is able to do that and people will use it because the trust is there. So that's the third. और उसके बाद the last one is called succession, and I'll tell you the words that he uses. He says तीर्थे. He says तीर्थे, नो, ही सेज वृद्धम तीर्थे प्रतिपादनीच. प्रतिपादन इज बिस्टोवल, गिव, एंड द तीर्थे ओवर हियर इज वन हु इज वर्दी, एंड वृद्धे इज मीन्स नॉट ओल्ड, एट एन एडवांस स्टेज. सो ही सेज व्हेन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, देन ऑफ कोर्स यू आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट किंगडम, व्हेन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रीचेस एन एडवांस स्टेज, then you hand it over to a suitable successor. So the last part is succession. So please say after me. The first one is creation. Let's say it loudly together. The second one is consolidation. The third part is expansion. The fourth part is succession. Can we say it once again? Everyone please. First part of leadership is creation. Second part is consolidation. Third part is expansion. Fourth part is succession. Now you can analyze any company and look at why it has succeeded or failed, including your own. Startups kahan fail hote hain? In the creation stage. Most of them never reach consolidation. We know only about, oh, we celebrate unicorns. Abhi to bachche hai. So, I mean, as companies, bachche hai. You know, in 5-7 years, we start saying, oh, they are so successful. Boss, are they going to last 10 years later? They may not be there. They fail. Only if you can move from creation to consolidation, you have covered the first step. Uske baad kya hota hai? Many small and medium-sized companies never reach expansion stage. Kyunki they run out of ideas. They don't know abhi kaise grow karna hai. So many companies actually start failing over there. The third one is expansion ke baad. Large companies including Infosys and the Tatas had difficulty in its succession, isn't it? Because from expansion, they either don't rethink ki abhi naya kya karna hai, or who is going to be the next leader. And then there are some companies who go through one cycle, but they never reach the spotting next opportunity stage. So leadership or a leader is one who can do all of this. Okay? So I'm going to now go to the last part of my presentation. I'll skip this because there's a lot of data which I have kept for you. But I will go straight to the part which I think will be most valuable to you. Lots of examples are there. Okay, so I worked with the Mahindra Group, and I want to tell you one of the quotes that Anand Mahindra has given, which I thought was very, very impressive. The opportunity to raise the quality of life is the biggest business opportunity going. Raising the quality of life, not standard of life. And this should be our entire aim, whether you are in healthcare, whether you are in mining, whether you are in pharma, are we raising the quality of life? Okay, last part. So, Pramod ji ne use kiya ek shabd. He said, Vivek. Lekin Bharat mein har shabd ke liye bahut sare shabd hai. So, I'm going to show you that there are three words which are used very commonly. One word is forgive the figure. It was meant to be a triangle. Pata nahi ye kaise ho gaya. The first word is buddhi. But is buddhi wisdom? Buddhi is intelligence. Buddhi is the intelligence that probably we got as our DNA itself from genetics. Doctor Saab here may have a better idea. Sorry, I don't know anything of genetics. But buddhi is a function of either your DNA or maybe your early stage growth. Then there is another shabd called Vivek. Vivek is actually not wisdom, it is discernment. I know it doesn't cover everything, but discernment. When you can make the right choice between that which is desirable or not desirable, good or bad, hot or cold, sad, happy, and so on. Choices. So wisdom ke liye the closest word is prajna or pragya, depending on which part of the country you are in. Prajna is generally the more accepted term. तो प्रज्ञा क्या है और इसको कैसे डेवलप करना है दैट आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू बट आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल थ्रू यू नो व्हाई आई हैव पुट अमूल ओवर हियर नॉट फॉर व्हाट दे डिड अर्लियर इवन दो द फोटो इज ऑफ डॉक्टर कुरियन वर्गिस बट व्हाट दे डिड ड्यूरिंग द पैंडेमिक डिड एनीवन स्टडी व्हाट अमूल डिड ड्यूरिंग द पैंडेमिक Please study. All dairy companies, milk product companies degrew. Amul grew by an additional 380 crores. A total amount of, I'll give you the figures. I can't remember it. Here are the figures that it did during pandemic. 39,200 crores, which was 698 crores more than their previous year. How? It's amazing. What a story. Ye, by the way, ye case available hai online. Please study kijiye. Everyone thought lockdown hai. So lockdown hai, that means everything is closed. Including the main sector being hospitality. Hotels, guest houses, sare band hai. So all the dairy manufacturers thought that our main customers are closed and baad mein after that also health problems. So dairy consumption will go down. So they started scaling down on their production. Sodhi Saab, who was the leader and still is the CMD of Amul, he had a lot of experiences studying from, you know, right from Kurian Varghese Saab to Amrita ma'am and then all of those who came after that. And he realized one thing. That whenever there is crisis, consumer behavior changes. But the need may not go away. So he realized that consumers will not take from hotels, restaurants, you know, the retail outlets, but they will not stop consuming dairy products. It will only change the way in which it comes. And they were bang on. So, at a time when everyone reduced their production, Amul introduced 33 new products. All of which succeeded except ice cream. Sirf ice cream category did not work. Everything else worked. Because people started consuming more and more dairy products at home. In fact, they stopped taking during the last, you know, 1.5 years or so. Bahut logon ne, recently, of course, things may have changed again. But in the last year, people stopped taking doodh from doodhwala because pata nahi hygienic rahega ki nahi. but they started taking the packaged products. And the only products which were always available in plenty were Amul's products. And I don't know if many of you all were like me watching Ramayana and Mahabharata. At least when you all were at home. Tabhi kaun se ad aate the Amul ke? All their old ads. Because they wanted to remind the public of all the ancient products to keep up with the theme. So Amul, 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 Amul in their mind. 33 new products. 39,200 crores the last year, 698 crore additional from previous year, 35 lakhs milk production, 35 lakh liters milk production daily, and they disperse 800 crore in bonus to every single dairy farmer, my dear friends. So what I want to share with you is that this does not come from knowledge, this comes from wisdom. And is Prajna developable? I'm going to leave one last framework with you. Arthashastra mein, there is a beautiful framework. And there is no such framework which I have come across in Western management so far. How to convert information to wisdom? Because information to explosion hai abhi. Everything is available on the net. So we think, oh, that is knowledge and that itself will give us wisdom. Not at all. That's just information. So Chanakya has given, I've given you the original terms and I've given you the English meanings of that closest jo aata hai. He says wisdom starts with Shushrusha. Shushrusha is the deep, Shushrusha again bahut sare arth hai, but Shushrusha over here means deep hunger for learning. If you don't have a deep hunger for learning, jaise aap sab log baithe hain yahan par, kal 7 session sune, aaj abhi tak already ye teesra session hai, nahi dusra session hai, and there are many more sessions, then you don't learn. Jab shushrusha rahega, deep hunger for learning, then you get shravan or deep listening. Not just listening, it's deep listening. Or agar listening hoga, shravan, then there will be grahan, which is absorbing. And if absorption happens, only then there will be dharan, which is reflection on that which we have absorbed. Already over here, information has been converted to knowledge through this. Because reflection is your first stage of knowledge. Reading or just, you know, getting from the net is not at all knowledge. Let's go through the second part of it. The fifth stage is Vidnyan. Vidnyan is not science over here. Vidnyan is building associations with past data and with future possibilities. Okay, past data and future possibility. My last slide. I'm conscious of the time, yeah? And wo, after completely mulling over that through Vidnyan, then you have many possibilities. Wo many possibilities ke liye, you will have to use the process of Uha and Apoha. Uha is selecting what is relevant now. Apoha is keeping in the folder for later. And therefore, selecting what's relevant, setting aside what's not relevant for the moment. And last but not the least, Tattva Abhinivesha, which is crystallizing what is relevant to me and working on it right now. You can think of this whole thing as a funnel, giant funnel. So, jaise chai patti se finally, or chai is what is useful, aap patti nahi khate. That chai, the nichod is coming at Tattva Abhinivesha. Chanakya says this is a process that every leader, who person who wants to be a leader should use on a daily basis. Dosto, please remember, I had shown in the previous slide which I did not spend time on. Today's knowledge has been reduced to cut, copy, paste, forward. Please correct me if I am wrong. Cut, copy, paste, forward, ye abhi That's all we do, and we think we have knowledge. So Professor Anil Gupta of IIM Ahmedabad, now retired, he once asked, folks, how many of you download things from the internet? Everyone. How many of you upload original content? Very few. So this is about creating knowledge. All right, so folks, we will close over here. There is a checklist which I am leaving for you. Aap isko agar study kare, it will help you a lot. All right, for every step I have given questions. This is for your usage. It's all available. Please make it available to all the users. So to end with, what do we need? Ownership of purpose, accountability towards people, responsibility of profits, 3 P's with the 4th P of Prajna. Okay, so yes, you can click if you want. I'll leave you with my coordinates. I had a beautiful story on Tenali Ram, but I'm not going to share it now. I'll probably record an audio and give it to them so that you can know. Tenali Ram is another great example, dear friends, jo hum sochte hain court jester hai. I don't know, we have this specialty as Indians to convert anything of value to something which is becomes a mockery. Tenali Ram was not joker and not a stand-up comedian, and you know, like many of the idiots that exist today. He was one of the Ashtadiggaj of Krishna Dev Rai's court, with a lot of wisdom, lot of presence of mind and wit. So not a joker, not a jester, another character to study. Okay, so I'm giving you my coordinates. If you wish to follow the path of Indian wisdom, or aap apne application mein lana chahte hain, I tell you, it is always possible. Bahut sare company, I'm very happy to report, have started using Indian wisdom fully in their organization. And I feel har Bharat ka jo citizen hai, everyone must learn, study and use this. Okay, so with that, namaste, thank you all of you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for this wonderful session. It was full of zeal and valuable information. Now, I really appreciate how your session was focused on India. We got to learn a lot. Now I request our team to bring the autograph pad for sir. Also, I would like to invite our convener, Sri Charles Juster, to present this.
Ha, sir, I'll read it, sir. This is the quote that we have received from sir, and that he usually believes in. Whatever happens with the organization's talent, whether it is success or setbacks, is the organization's leader who is responsible. An ownership
always
statement.
Any attrition, any engagement is the responsibility of the leader, period. Not the yes.
A statement of ownership.
Yes,
can
absolutely
we have the memento, please?
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bahut bahut dhanyawad aap sabko, and I really hope this has produced some interest in your mind who already don't have it to study a little bit more. Yehi meri ek aasha hai. My stated purpose is to bring Indian wisdom back to all Indians. That's all you need to do. Har cheez mein, koi bhi field mein, engineering ho, management ho, aapko solution milega. Yeah? Thank you so much. Thanks so much, Charles. Great pleasure.
Thank you so much, sir. So, this was Sri Rajesh Kamat, sir. Sir, it was really, you know, electrifying, energetic, enthralling, full of positivity, and what not, I should say. It was such a brilliant experience being with you on board. And we'll be starting with... For the next session, I would be inviting Dr. Ashwin Nayak, sir. There's a bit of change in the schedule.
Dr. Ashwin Nayak is an author and award-winning entrepreneur. He is widely regarded as an expert on affordable healthcare innovation, scaling social impact, and mental well-being at work. As an entrepreneur, he has started multiple healthcare organizations like Platform for Preventive Mental Health, Helpline for Mental Health Support During COVID-19, and Vatsalya, India's first rural hospitals network. Author of books Keep Calm and Lead On, The Healthcare Game Changers, which profiles innovations around the world which have the potential to change the way healthcare is delivered. He is a TED Fellow and a young global leader of the World Economic Forum. He has been honored Economic Times Leader Under 40, Young Leader by Asia Society, Asia 21 in 2011, Inspiring Entrepreneurs of India. He is speaking on well-being and happiness as key competencies for higher employee engagement in Shram 2021.
It's a pleasure to have you, sir, with us at this Singrauli HR conference. May I request the convener for this HR conference, Sri Charles Justice, sir, to kindly present him a floral bouquet as a mark of respect. Shawl and Shrifal as well. We have also come to know about the importance of Shrifal being presented by Sri Rajesh Kamath, sir, that will be imbibing and remembering forever. Welcome again, sir, and I request you to kindly come up and present yourself. Thank you.
Call on mic.
Thank you.
Pawan, Pawan, just a second.
Can you hear me?
Chair, sir.
No. Can you hear me now? Okay. Great. First of all, thank you to the organizers for inviting me today to speak on this important topic. But it's very difficult to speak after Rajesh. As you have seen, he has set the bar so high. It's going to be very tough for anybody to follow his lead. And my topic is very different from his topic. And my topic is a little sad topic, if you say, you know, if you compare to what he has spoken about. But I will try my best because employee well-being, as you all know, has become an extremely important topic in this age. So what I'm going to do is, quickly if I get a sense of who all is in the room. How many of you are HR professionals? All right, pretty much everybody. How many of you are in managerial positions? Okay, about 50%. How many of you are in your first job? Okay, great, thank you. Sir has also raised his hand as as first job, but yeah. I think that's a good spirit. Every job is a first job for us. So let me start with telling you two stories, and then I want to share three trends which are shaping employee well-being, and then end with about four things that we can do as individuals, as employees, as organizations for employee well-being. I also, given that we are already running late, I will try to compress my remarks to maybe half an hour or so, and we can do some Q&A after that. So the first story that I want to share with you is of a young individual, about 28, 29 years old, who got recently married about 2 years ago and is facing domestic problem. And this is not novel, right? This happens in all kinds of communities, all societies. Recently married, having domestic issues at home. And office may obviously this will impact their performance, performance is affected, etc. And then you get a news that this person has died by suicide. Is this unusual? Is this not unheard of? Have you heard of these kind of things happening in your own companies and in your own neighborhoods? I think over the last 5 years, this has become even more prominent. And one of the reasons we think is young people are struggling to handle their lives. Young people are struggling to make decisions. Young people are struggling to make decisions because in the past, somebody else used to make decision for us. We used to have a senior person in the family. Kabhi dada ji ho gaye, kabhi tao ji ho gaye, kabhi koi to decision karte the. Now we have to take care of our own decisions. And it's a big, big pressure on all of us. And what is not happening is young people are not being taught the skills of how to manage your emotional well-being. And when they come to work, they expect you to be also responsible for that. And that's where the main challenge lies. And this is one of the areas that I want to focus on. The second aspect, particularly for the youngsters, is when you look at exam season, when you see people, you know, your own families, when you have young children in college and school, and they're preparing for exam, the most stressful period in their lives is when the exam result comes. So many young people are losing their lives after the exam result comes. You will not believe, last year, last full year, every day 35 young children have lost their lives because of these kind of issues, right? They don't know what to do when the expectation is so high. So these are two stories, one for young people and one for somebody who is starting the job. And how do we manage these kind of issues? So the reason I think, and most of us here are also interested in this, is how do we create an environment of support for people who are going through these issues, particularly in a company environment. Now my question to you is, why is it so difficult to talk about these issues? I'd like to hear one or two answers from you. Why is it difficult? Kyunki suppose abhi kisi, in some community somebody has died of suicide, most people say ki, "Are, I did not know this person was in so much trouble. I did not know that this person was, if I knew, I would have supported." How is it that we are not able to find these issues? How is it that people who are under stress, not able to talk about it? Anybody, any suggestions? Why is it difficult for us to talk about well-being, particularly about mental health? Yes, sir. Can you pass on a mic to him, please?
Sir, this is Panigrahi from Dredging Corporation of India. Thing is that people actually hesitate to express this kind of problem to others. And most of the time, people don't know that this is a kind of problem. It is actually self-awareness that this is a kind of problem and it may take away the life also. So yeah. Self-awareness, there is a lack of self-awareness.
Absolutely. Lack of awareness is number one. We have one, somebody here. Yes. Yeah. Go ahead, please. Can you get a mic to, there are one, two, three people here.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are expected and taught to be winners. And asking for help when we are facing mental issues is openly accepting that we have lost it.
Absolutely. I think this is a very important point. Asking for help is considered as weakness. Right? And we are not expected to do that as professionals. So we'll come back to that. Awareness, asking for help. We have two more questions.
I think we still think it is a stigma. Like if we ask, it's a weakness for us. So people generally don't share.
Yes, it is a stigma and we are afraid to share with somebody else. Yes, sir.
Family discussion or friend, best friend, is not working after using social media. This type of communication gap is reason.
So, aap keh rahe hain ki because of social media, we are not able to build relationships with family, with friends, etc. Absolutely. Sir, aap.
Sir, इंडिया में कोई समझेगा नहीं इसलिए कोई बोलता नहीं सर समझ बोलने के बाद भी कोई समझेगा नहीं सामने वाला तो मेंटल इश्यूज आर नॉट बीन ट्रीटेड एज अ मेंटल इश्यूज ओवर हियर डिप्रेशन इज ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर नॉट बीन ट्रीटेड एज अ डिजीज
तो यस एब्सोल्युटली यस जस्ट
कैन यू हियर मी मोस्ट ऑफ द पॉइंट्स हैव ऑलरेडी बीन कवर्ड बाय देम सर टू थिंग्स आई वुड लाइक टू स्पीक One is the problems they are facing are very personal, that can't be shared out to people, you know, somebody, to a colleague or anybody at the workplace.
Yeah.
The other part is the people undergoing these problems, they know very well that they are facing something, but then the other available options to them, other than a psychiatrist, like, you know, a counselor or a psychologist or somebody to guide them, exploring these options, you know, is something which many don't see it as an option. If you have a mental illness or you're facing some, you know, a difficulty, and you think psychiatrist is the only fellow who can deal with you.
Sure.
So exploring these other things are always left out.
Even when they know they need help, they don't know where to go. Absolutely.
Sir, एक और चीज होती है. पहली चीज तो ये रहती है कि अगर हम अपनी समस्याएं किसी से बताएंगे, तो उसका बाद में मजाक उड़ाया जाता है.
जी.
अभी जब तक समस्या तब तक ठीक है. बाद में लोग हंसेंगे कि भाई इनके घर में ऐसी दिक्कत आ रही थी.
जी.
दूसरी चीज क्या होता है कि जो हमारे बॉसेज होते हैं वो काफी ओल्ड एज होते हैं घर में उनके बच्चे होते नहीं वो लोग मतलब बच्चे लोग बाहर पढ़ रहे होते हैं ज्यादातर टाइम वो ऑफिस में बिताते हैं और वो क्या एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं जो जूनियर्स हैं कि वो भी रात में 8 बजे तक 9 बजे तक ऑफिस में बैठे हैं ठीक है अब दिक्कत क्या होती है सर कि उनके घर में तो क्या होगा कि वो ड्राइवर वगैरह कोई भी है तो जाके सब्जी वगैरह ला देते हैं अब 8 बजे घर से आप निकलोगे सब्जी लाना किराना लाना ये सब जाएंगे आप ऑफिस में जब घर पहुंचते हो 9 बज जाते हैं उसके बाद पत्नी बोलेगी ठीक है बच्चों को पकड़ो तो हम खाना बनाएंगे ठीक है अब वहां पे रोज मतलब ये झगड़े होने ही है तो वहां पे टेंशन अब इधर ऑफिस में बॉस बोलता है कि भाई आप काम नहीं करते ढंग से आपका मन नहीं लगता है दिन भर घर घर की चिंता रहती है तो ये जो मेंटल टेंशन सर क्रिएट हो जाती है आप यहाँ पे अच्छा परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाते क्योंकि बॉस को आप हमेशा खुश नहीं कर पाते 6 बजे किस दिन चले जाएंगे तो दिक्कत रहती है और
मैं समझता हूँ आपकी
और वाइफ है वो बोलती है बच्चों को पढ़ाओगे नहीं आप मतलब बच्चे 5 साल के हो गए ABCD नहीं बन रहे काका नहीं बन रहे वो भी दिक्कत है
श्योर मैं आपकी बात समझ रहा हूँ सो जो आप कह रहे हैं उसको अगर समराइज किया जाए तो हाउ टू मैनेज वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस
राइट
एब्सोल्युटली दिस इज अ बिग टॉपिक एंड इसके बारे में बात करें हम और मेन थिंग जो आप सब लोगों ने बताई है स्टिग्मा एक्सेस डिस्कशन अबाउट मेंटल हेल्थ और ये सब इसको मैं दो डिवाइड करना चाहता हूँ वाई इज इट डिफिकल्ट टू टॉक अबाउट मेंटल हेल्थ एंड हाउ इज द वर्ल्ड लुकिंग एट इट इन द फ्यूचर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जब आपकी बॉडी को कुछ प्रॉब्लम होता है जब आपको कुछ दर्द होता है तो योर बॉडी टेल्स योर ब्रेन कि मुझे यहाँ दर्द हो रहा है मुझे ये हो रहा है एंड देन यू आर एबल टू आर्टिकुलेट इट बट आपके जब टेंशन होता है स्ट्रेस होता है ब्रेन टेल हु डज द ब्रेन टेल इट टू व्हेन यू हैव समथिंग ऑन योर माइंड हु डज द ब्रेन टेल इट टू सॉरी आई कांट हियर यू लिवर एंड किडनी एब्सोल्युटली सो व्हेन देयर इज स्ट्रेस ऑन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स इन अवर बॉडी राइट फॉर एग्जांपल लैक ऑफ स्लीप you know, having some diseases, right? So underlying everything is mental issues. The reason I am talking about this is, many people think ki mental illness and mental health is the same thing. I want to leave you with one thing today, if I can leave you. Mental health and mental illness is not the same thing. Mental illness wo cheez hoti hai, jahan pe aapko clinically kuch problem hai, जहाँ पे ट्रीटमेंट है साइकियाट्रिस्ट है ये है right? Mental health is for everybody. 20 years ago, when 20, maybe 30 years ago, when people used to go to the gym, the only people who used to go to the gym were bodybuilders. Aaj ki date mein agar aap gym nahin jaate, so people are seen as, aray, aap gym nahin jaate ho. Similarly, all of us have the ability and the requirement to learn mental health skills. Just like we are learning physical health skills, mental health skills also can be learned. So my first takeaway for you is, please do not confuse mental illness with mental health. We all need mental health. We all can be better as managers, as parents, as employees, and there is a way to develop that mental health, and that can be helped to yourself, by yourself, and also through organizational methods. So with that, let me touch upon three important trends that we are seeing. The first trend, sir, aapne jo boli, work-life balance. In Western countries, if you read the news now, almost 40% of employees are quitting their jobs. And the reason for quitting the jobs, in the top three, is what you mentioned, work-life balance. Particularly young people, they are saying, I don't want to trade my life for work. I want to have a balance. And if you don't give me the balance, I'm going to resign. So they are calling, McKinsey is calling it the great resignation. Lots of people are going to leave their jobs because of this. So what does it mean for all of us who are in managerial positions and in HR roles is we have to think of employee well-being as a core function of HR. And this is going to be even more important in the next 5 to 10 years. So that's number one trend. The number two trend that we feel is employee well-being is something which companies considered as a benefit. Ki ye ek unko kuch support de do and leave it. I don't think that is true. In the future, employee well-being will be a leadership skill. Taking care of your employees' well-being is going to be an important skill that managers will have to learn and be trained for. If you want to be a manager, how to take care of your employees will be a number one skill. Like Simon Sinek, an organizational psychologist, has said, leadership is not being in charge. Leadership is taking care of people whom you are in charge of. That will become a significant role. So the first role is that well-being will become a key skill. Second is it will become a skill that you'll have to learn. And the third one is young people will decide which companies they will join or leave depending on what kind of well-being support you provide. See, our parents' generation and some of their parents' generation, the first requirement was stability of their job, some income, and making sure that family is taken care of. Today the generation is different. We want everything. We want life, we want work, we want a balance of that. So that is changing rapidly, and organization will have to change accordingly. So these are the three trends we are seeing. Now, if these are the trends, what is it that we can do as individuals, as managers, as organizations, and also ourselves as employees? What can we do? The first thing that we think, and we work with large organizations like banks, we also work with small startups, and the first thing that we tell organizations is to start a conversation. Start a conversation that it is true. I mean, employees are already talking about it, management is not aware. So how do we create that conversation that this mental health issue or emotional well-being is a real thing? And I want to share one example of a company which is doing it nicely, and now the program is available for everybody to use. This was started by a company, DuPont. The program is very simple. It is called ICU. It's very easy to remember, ICU. I stands for identify, C stands for connect, and U stands for understand. It's very simple. As an employee, like all of you said, it's very difficult to find out what is going on in the other person's life, how should I support them, and how do I make sure that they are taken care of. So this three steps of identify, connect, and understand will be very useful, and there are programs that you can that you can see online, which will be helpful for this program. So how do we start as organizations? First step is sensitizing people about what are the different kinds of mental health challenges, emotional well-being challenges people might suffer in their jobs. It could be related to policy, it could be related to timing of work, it could be related to other things as well. But unless our managers are aware that these are real issues affecting the youngsters, they'll not be able to take care of that. The second one is, how do you create a safe space? You know, I'm very happy that you are able to stand up and say ki ye work-life ka challenge hai. Unless people don't have the space to come out and say ki this is the challenge, it will never get fixed. So how do you create this safe space for people to come up and speak? And the third thing jo aapne batai ki humko malum hi nahi hai kya karna hai. One of the ways that organizations handle this is creating what is called well-being ambassadors, well-being champions within the organization. So as HR leaders or as business leaders, what you can think of is, how do I train, you know, 150 of my people to become well-being ambassadors, who can be the first point of contact. And yesterday I was talking to Mr. Soni and he mentioned how in his own organization he was able to find one or two examples that there is some problem with this person, right? Poor performance theek nahi hai, acha kaam karte the, suddenly there is change in behavior, or if they are stressed in a coal mine situation, and he recommended them to go to a professional. Now somebody who is a manager or in a position of authority, when they recommend you go and see, I think the compliance will be much better. So how do we create more well-being ambassadors, well-being champions? So this is the third way of doing it. And finally, like I said in the very beginning, the most important thing is all of us to start this conversation. So I would encourage you to start this conversation today by doing a simple exercise. Turn to the person on the right of you and share what is it that is bothering you in your life, and be honest. We will take about 2 to 3 minutes. Just share. It doesn't matter if you know the person, doesn't know the person, but the ability to share ki aapki life mein what is it that is stressful or challenging, can you share with the person on your right for 3 minutes? If you are with your spouse, especially, please do that. Okay, I can see a lot of people talking, but some of you are very quiet. All right, anybody wants to share one or two things that you shared with your person on your right? Yes, sir. Anybody wants to share on this side? Yes, we have somebody here.
Somebody please हेलो सर, आवाज आ रही
है? यस
सर, ये काफ़ी दूर से चली आई है वो बात जो मैं बता रहा हूँ, उसमें मेरा भी ओपिनियन साथ में ही है। सर, कुछ लोगों के ऐसे दोहरे चरित्र होते हैं, आप सामने से उनको देखेंगे तो वो उनसे बेहतर कोई नहीं है
जी,
वही जब रियल जहाँ पे काम करते हैं वहाँ पर आप उनको देखेंगे तो उनके स्टैंडर्ड कुछ अलग ही है। ऐसी सिचुएशन में सर, ऐसी सिचुएशन में उन लोगों के लिए मुश्किल हो जाता है जो उनके अंडर काम करते हैं
जी।
सर, आपको एक एग्जांपल बताऊंगा। सर, आप किसी भी स्तर के देख लो, हमारी कंपनी से मैटर नहीं है, हर जगह यही हाल है। अगर आपको गवर्नमेंट या सेमी गवर्नमेंट या पीएसयू है तो इतने सालों से विजिलेंस अवेयरनेस वीक मनाया जाता रहा है।
कौन सा अवेयरनेस वीक?
विजिलेंस अवेयरनेस वीक।
यस, यस।
मैं किसी संगठन को प्रश्न चिन्ह नहीं लगा रहा हूँ, लेकिन ये हकीकत है। उसके बावजूद भी उस संगठन में चाहे आपको कितनी ही कंप्लेंट पेंडिंग हो, ऐसे इश्यू रेज किए हो, लेकिन वो चीज़ें उन पर अमल करने के बजाय उस पर खर्च करेंगे पोस्टर बैनर प्रतियोगिताएं, उनसे सर वो होना नहीं है इमेज जो सुधरनी चाहिए
जी।
ये एक एग्जाम्पल बता रहा हूँ, ऐसे हजारों एग्जाम्पल है सर। तो मेन इश्यू होता है सर कि मैं जो हूँ वो एटलीस्ट सामने दिखूँ, यहाँ सामने बोल दूंगा कि मेरे अंडर में जो काम कर रहे हैं उनको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होनी चाहिए, यहाँ से माइक हटते ही जाके उन्हीं को सबसे पहले कि तुम लोग आ जाओ। तो सर ये थोड़ा सा
एब्सोल्युटली राइट। एक्चुअली ये चीज़ बहुत कॉमन है लार्ज कंपनीज में, क्योंकि जो डिस्कनेक्ट होता है बिटवीन द पीपल हु आर ऑन द ग्राउंड हु आर डूइंग द वर्क एंड द मैनेजमेंट इज वेरी हाई। आई विल शेयर यू वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ हाउ वन कंपनी वॉज एबल टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम। मैं ये विजिलेंस वगैरह का तो मुझे कुछ मालूम नहीं है, वेलनेस के बारे में कुछ बताना चाहता हूँ। सो वेलबींग का भी यही चैलेंज चल रहा था कि एम्प्लॉयज वर आस्किंग फॉर इट, बट कंपनी वॉज सेइंग कि अरे कुछ भी प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं है, हम तो सब वी हैव पॉलिसीज, सब पॉलिसीज तो अच्छी हैं, हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस दे रहे हैं, इतनी बड़ी हॉस्पिटल है, ये है। तो एचआर मैनेजर ने एक अच्छा आइडिया किया, व्हाट इज इट दैट अब से जो भी वेलबींग पॉलिसीज होंगी वो एम्प्लॉई टीम्स ही लॉन्च करेंगी और एम्प्लॉई टीम्स ही उनको इम्प्लीमेंट करेंगी। सो दे क्रिएटेड दिस एम्प्लॉई क्लब्स वेयर द एम्प्लॉईज देमसेल्व्स विल आइडेंटिफाई इश्यूज एंड देन गेट इट इम्प्लीमेंटेड with full responsibility, and the management's role was to only approve the budget, saying okay if there is a budget required ye kar lo. I think that is now creating a lot of output. For example, this company is a large agriculture manufacturer called Syngenta, aapne suna hoga ye company ka, it is now recognized as a good practice as well. Even coming closer to home, टाटा ग्रुप कंपनीज में भी काफ़ी एम्फोसिस है ऑन एम्प्लॉई एंगेजमेंट एंड एम्प्लॉई वेलफेयर विच इज़ रन लार्जली बाय द एम्प्लॉई टीम। सो ऐसी कुछ ये हो सकती हैं, बट यू नो यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट, द डिस्कनेक्ट इज़ वेरी हाई बिटवीन व्हाट द एम्प्लॉईज नीड एंड समटाइम्स व्हाट द मैनेजमेंट नीड्स। सो हमारी कंपनी व्हाट वी ऑल्सो डू इज हेल्प आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस, हेल्प identify the challenges by doing an assessment. Just like you do a skills assessment, you can also do a emotional well-being assessment of a company, of an employee group, or the entire organization, and say, okay, these are the challenges that employees are facing from an emotional well-being point. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, good afternoon. I'm Kamna Sharma from NTPC Limited.
Yeah.
Sir, we are facing this challenge, as you stated, it's a very relevant topic, and I appreciate NCL for opening this forum in such an open forum. Sir, we have psychological counseling with us, which we have outsourced to certain agency called Snehal. And we have even broadcasted to all our employees.
Absolutely.
But what I see is that there is very
less
people joining it.
Yeah.
How do we handle it? The issue is that I have seen we get the request, like the board examination which you were sharing, the employee's child had run away from the house, and we could, with the help of police, we had to, and we have a Snehal policy, and when we consulted the employee and his wife, ke bhai, we have that Snehal policy, if the child is not sharing with you, kindly register him to that but then the people were not forthcoming. No, no, it's we'll counsel him, we'll handle it, madam, it is not an issue. So how do we handle this?
Yes, absolutely. Sir. So this is the most common question we get from HR professionals, not only in India, but we also work with companies in Singapore. Companies will do all they can. For example, helpline hai, counselor hai, psychologist hai, they will appoint. But then it turns out that nobody is using. Globally, the utilization of a psychologist on campus is less than 5%. In India, it is less than 2%. Why is it that? The companies are struggling, large companies are struggling, saying we have already appointed. And the main reason that we sort of found out is two main reasons. One, that service is something that the employee has to call. Right? Now, unka jo inertia hai to call this psychologist helpline or to go book an appointment is very high. Aur unko dar bhi rehta hai ki agar main ye kar dun to kisi ko pata chal jaye. So that's number one. Number two is, how many of you in your lives have met a psychologist? One. See, in maybe two, three. In the entire room, there are less than 10 people who have met a psychologist. Agar aap kisi ko mile hi nahi ho, to unse kaise aap kaise trust hoga ki unse aapko help milega. If I ask you how many of you met a pediatrician, how many of you met a gynecologist, how many met a physician, every hand will go up. To aapko malum hai, agar ye problem hai, to inke paas ja sakte. So two main important things. One, make sure that your psychologist is visible. Unse baat karaiye, jo bhi hai employees, small groups, 20-25 people, regular sessions karwaiye, jahan wo dekh sake ki ye person hai. Aur nahi to ye experience hai. Jo hamari company mein, because we are a remote company, we are not physically present. What we do is, when we come on board a company, we make sure that every employee spends 30 minutes with our psychologist. Not about anything, just to talk about what are the challenges, what do they want to do as an employee, as a manager, so that rapport is built. So tomorrow, if their child or themselves, they want some support, they will say, okay, I can talk to so and so in this company. So that is number one. And second is making sure that it is not a system where employee has to call. That rapport should already be built. And it is not your challenge, madam. We have seen it in so many companies. The second point I would add to this is what he also mentioned, is create an environment where they can talk to somebody else within the organization, not a psychologist. Suppose aapke company mein, I don't know, 5,000, 10,000 people hai, designate 100 people who can be the first point of contact to talk to, solve some problems, and they can say, okay, you might want to talk to a psychologist or a psychiatrist. So hopefully that will help. Anybody else had any questions or remarks about the discussion? I'll take one more last question. I think we are sort of running short of time, but give me a... No? Okay, great. So hopefully this conversation was useful about well-being at work. I want to recap what we just discussed. One is starting with creating a space where we can have more conversations like this, and realizing that employee well-being is going to be a core skill in the future, and all of us as leaders, managers will have to be equipped with it. And as organizations, we can create small, not very large, but small opportunities for employees to share and also to seek help as needed. As you know that mental health and well-being is becoming extremely important given the situation with COVID, but in the future also we believe that this will become a very key element of what you as HR professionals will have to deal with. So I hope that this discussion has given you some ideas, and I'm happy to share more. The organizers have my contact details, and if you need anything, please get in touch with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Shri Ashwin Nayak sir presented his thoughts over mental wellness, and we hope that you'll all be benefited and we'll stay in touch, sir. We'll stay in touch with you if at all we need your guidance and support at any point of time. With this, I would request my colleague to kindly present that the autograph pad with the favorite quote of Dr. Ashwin Nayak sir, quote on that.
The world and all our workplaces are undergoing a great reset. The time is ripe for the human resource professionals to think of their roles differently in the new normal. A role which is more strategic, integrates well-being of employees along with the performance, and enables them to become a champion of how the new world of work should look like. With this, we would request Dr. Ashwin Nayak sir to please present his autograph. Thank you so much, sir.
May I now request our convener, Sri Charles Justice sir, to kindly present him a token of love, a memento him being present at SHRAM 2021, the first of its kind HR conference being organized at Singrauli.
Okay,
thank you so much, sir. Thank you once again for being with us in this mega HR conclave. The time is ripe enough for lunch, I suppose. But before that, a few announcements to make. The entire program is being telecasted live on YouTube and our Facebook page as well. You can visit our YouTube channel, Northern Coalfields Limited, and can join us. And we'll also be having a session of Professor Shiv Khera from 6 p.m. onwards. Shaam ko 6 baje se hai, and I request you all to attend the same. And we'll be gathering back in the auditorium at 2 o'clock after lunch. Maybe please proceed for lunch. Thank you so much.
Liye saab se autograph kamat saab se, haan.